Okay. Let's go to the Normandy.
Your biotics are coming along nicely. In the last fight, it looked like you even surprised yourself.
I've always held back a little when I used my powers on living targets. Fear of hurting someone, I guess. But after what I saw in Eden Prime, I'm not holding back anymore. Not against a Geth, not against anyone.
Caden's getting a little bit loose. Okay, so we need to wrap up a few quests. We need to talk to Walter Fizz and the Horsehead Nebula. Inspect Normandy. Any other inspection stuff? Nope. Okay. No. There is the hull. Is that out here? Or am I too far away? Probably a little bit too far away. That one is a little bit wonky, I must admit. Wait, is there one of the engines? Ah, the light. Okay, no, there's none in the engines. To the Horsehead Nebula. Now we need to go rescue a kidnappee and find out what happened to some missing privateers.
Stand by, shore party.
Decontamination in progress.
Decontamination.
Rightio.
The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Actually, we're gonna go talk to Garrus and Rex real quick. And Liara. We'll talk to Liara first. I don't think Kaden is gonna have anything to add, but I don't think it would hurt to find out. So we'll talk to everybody real quick. Get an idea of where everybody stands. Romance, Miss Liara, right here. Oh, hi!
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Tell me more about you.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I was talking about my interest in you, and making a fool of myself in the process. As I said, I am not used to dealing with people, especially humans. I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously.
Well, thanks.
Your kind always seemed so rushed and high-strung.
We're short-lived.
We don't have the luxury of time, and the Asari can live for 1,000 years. We're lucky if we hit 150.
That is true. At first I thought that was a weakness of your species. After spending time with you and your crew, however, I think it may actually be an advantage. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable determination. It is an admirable trait, but also an intimidating one.
Why so?
You're scared of us?
Unfortunately, the rest of the galaxy sees humanity as something of a bully. You run over anyone in your path to get what you want. It is up to people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
I am trying.
I'm doing the best I can, Liara.
There is a reason the Council chose you to become a Spectre. They saw something special in you. The best of what humanity has to offer. I looked into your history. I know what you did during the Blitz. It was a remarkable display of courage and heroism.
Well, thanks, but you could have asked.
You didn't need to go behind my back. I would have told you whatever you wanted to know.
I apologize, Commander. After our last conversation, I was afraid I would say something stupid again. I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the man you are. There is something compelling about you, Shepard.
Something that made you into the man you are. Wow, that's... You can hear it in the voice. Initially, Liara was sort of designed for Shepard. You know, designed to be the initial romance character. So a lot of the way, or a lot of the things that Liara says sort of is meant to attract you to her. If that makes sense. I want to believe that.
Are you sure you're interested in me? Or is it my visions of the Protheans?
I admit, your connection to the Protheans had something to do with my initial interest. But it has grown beyond that.
Ooh.
You intrigue me, Shepard.
Well, thanks.
But I was not sure if it was appropriate to act on my feelings. I thought there might already be a relationship between you and Chief Williams.
It's not serious.
Williams and I are just friends, nothing more.
My mistake, then. I am not as adept at understanding human relationships as I thought. But what about us, Shepard? Is there a mutual attraction, or was I wrong about that, too?
Hey, here we go, romance path. I am attracted to you.
No, you were right. There is something between us.
We've only spoken twice.
I knew it, and I knew you felt it, too. But does this not seem rather strange? Why do I feel so close to you?
Because I'm amazing.
We have only known each other a short time.
Yeah.
We are from two different species. We have almost nothing in common. This makes no sense.
Yep. That's normally how these things go. It doesn't have to.
These things never make sense. They just happen and we get swept up in the storm.
You make it sound so chaotic. So dangerous.
Oh my god. I'll protect you.
I'll keep you safe.
I am not looking for a protector. This is all a bit overwhelming. I am not used to this. You. I need some time.
I get that.
Take all the time you need, Liara. I'll be here.
Thank you, Shepard. Let's just talk about something else for now.
Nothing else to talk about.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
That's, a really cheesy romance right there. Not against it, but at the same time, it's just... It could have been better. More in depth, I suppose. As opposed to speaking to a person twice and be like, hey, we're gonna fuck not. What's up, Caden? My man.
Anything you need, Commander?
Personal input.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
Well, they know about the stonewalling you've had from the Council.
Good.
They deserve to know what we're up against.
They're on your side. They're pissed about the resistance we're getting, especially from our side. I'll have a better handle on all of it when my head stops hurting. Another L2 flare up.
You alright?
Anything I can do?
No, Commander, it'll settle down. It's rough sometimes, but they spike higher than a lot of L3s. Except for you, of course. Besides, I fared a lot better than some after Kinetics was through.
They still run?
I haven't heard anything about Kinetics in a while.
Yeah, they quietly disappeared. Broke up into a bunch of little corps after they botched the training on Jump Zero. After first contact, Kinetics was set up to track Element Zero exposures and develop implants for humans. Once we had an embassy on the Citadel, Kinetics could bring in experts instead of taking it slow.
Okay, why couldn't we do it alone?
Is there why didn't they do it alone? We couldn't learn it on our own?
They didn't know where to start. Hell, it took a couple of years to even link Biotics and Ezo. Forget trying to get the kids to move stuff. They had trouble just helping them not break their own limbs. And their choice of teachers didn't help much.
Yeah. What about the experts?
The only experts would have to be aliens.
Dead on. Turians, actually. That's why Kinetics kept it a secret.
That's odd.
They were afraid of what people back home would think, asking the Turians for help when we just fought a war with them.
Why not the Asari? Seems the more logical choice.
The Asari would have been more acceptable than the Turians.
Yes, but the company didn't go through the Citadel. It would have made Earth look weak, so they discreetly hired some Turian mercenaries.
Of course. Always with the mercs. I'm not sure they meant well. No, wait. No, I am sure they meant well.
I'm sure Kinetics did what they thought was best.
It wasn't best for us. They brought in an ex-military Turian named Commander Vernus. A real hard ass. He basically had a free pass to break us if it would turn out a decent biotic. Kind of spiraled from there, Commander.
They ever bust the guy?
Did he ever face charges for that?
He got his, yeah. But like everything else at Jump Zero, it was under the table. The less said, the better. Anyway, this is ancient stuff. I walked it off a long time ago. I should get back to my duties, Commander. We're here to make history, not rehash it.
Fair enough.
Talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
That sucks. I believe there is a comic regarding what happened to Kaden. But I don't remember it in grave detail. I know some shit went down. Next up on our shit list is Garrus. My man. The man of the hour. Quick little save.
Commander, I wanted to thank you.
For?
What for, Garrus? For everything. Taking me with you, letting me be part of your team. I've learned a lot. I've thought a lot about what you've told me. About not sacrificing innocence to achieve the goal. About finding the best way through, not just the fastest. And I've been thinking about Dr. Salion, too. I'd convinced myself that he deserved to die, but then I started thinking about why I wanted him dead. I realized it wasn't because of what he did to those people. That was part of it, but I think most of it was because he got away from me. He escaped under my watch, and I didn't like that. I let it become personal.
Is that it?
Words mean nothing until you turn them into action, Garrus. What are you going to do about it?
Well, I'm going back to CSEC. I think I can make a difference there. I'll also reapply for Spectre training, but I'll do it right. I won't compromise myself to get there. If the people I'm sworn to protect can't trust me, then I don't deserve to be the one protecting them.
That's good to hear, Garrus.
I'm glad you see it that way. Keep that in mind when we meet Saren.
Don't worry, Commander. I will.
Okay, so I think we just finished what Garrus had to say. Rex, my man. Ready to talk some shit again?
Never a dull moment with you, Shepard.
Uh-huh.
Do you ever go on any missions like ours before?
Saving the galaxy from certain destruction? No. But I've had my share of adventures.
Oh, adventures, you say?
Do you remember any that stick out?
A few. I remember one time I was hired by a Volus diplomat. What an ass.
Okay. The Volus diplomat.
I guess even politicians have need of mercs from time to time, huh?
Time to time. If it wasn't for politicians, I'd be out of work. They're always looking for ways to get ahead. This one was no different. He wanted me to erase his past. Get rid of an old friend who knew too much. Huh. His old friend turned out to be an Asari commando.
Oh. Okay, so what happened?
I can see why that might give you pause.
What? No. Alina and I were old friends. Sort of. We met when we were both contracted to kill the same Turian. Neither of us wanted the other one to get him first. We spent more time fighting each other than tracking that Turian.
She was a merc?
An Asari commando mercenary? That's unusual, isn't it?
I wouldn't say it's unusual. Mercs come in all shapes. Anyway, when I told Alina about the diplomat's contract, she and I had a good laugh about it.
Then what?
So what did you do?
Well, I wasn't going to lose the contract, but I respected Alina. In the end, I let her pick the location where we'd fight. She chose some old Solarian space station overrun with mercs and smugglers. That way we didn't have to worry about hurting any innocent bystanders. She always was a bit of a softie.
What happened to her?
What happened on the station?
What didn't happen? For 2 days, I chased her through that station. Used my entire store of ammunition. Had to kill a bunch of mercs and use their crap weapons. By the third day, the station was barely holding together. The mercs were dead or gone. Life support was failing. But I had her. She'd locked herself in the med labs. She was trying to patch herself up. Damn tough, that one. Then just when I thought I had her, the station's core went critical. Barely made it back to my ship in time.
Did she get out?
I assume the Asari commando didn't make it?
I watched the station from a distance. I never saw her leave. And when that place blew, there was nothing left larger than a Turian's right nut. So I headed back to the diplomat to give him the good news and collect my pay. But before I got halfway there, Alina sent me a message. Better luck next time. Now, I'm not superstitious, but if someone can survive that, well, they deserve to live. At least for a bit longer.
And the Wallace?
What about the diplomat? He wanted her dead.
I told him the truth. Alina was still alive and she was really pissed. I told him if he wanted to live, he'd need me around to protect him.
You told him that?
And he believed you.
He kept me on as his personal guard until he died. Natural causes. Easiest job I've ever had. A little boring, but credits are credits.
God damn it.
So long, Rex.
Alina, total badass. I'm not actually sure we get to meet her. Come to think of it, I don't think we do. But she sounds like a total badass. Tally, we need to talk to Ashley again. Break things off before she gets carried away.
Shepard, I'm glad you're here.
I'm glad you're feeling better.
Good to see you smiling again, so to speak.
I'm sleeping much better now. I guess I'm getting used to how quiet your ship is. But I don't want this to get in the way of our mission, Shepard. First, we stop Saren. Then I'll worry about my own problems.
Okay.
I should go.
That was easy enough. Let's go talk to Ashley. She's going to be slightly very upset. Hey, Ashley.
Commander?
How we doing?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her... Hey, you want to ask her about her sex life?
I don't think...
Let's just... Yeah. Nothing new there. We may need to do an actual mission before she reveals any more to us. Okay, so we need to go to the Horsehead Nebula. And then we need to go find the privateers. And then we need to go rescue a hostage. It's quite a to-do list right there. Up and away.
Message okay. Coming in.
Oh.
Patching it through.
Commander, Ms. Al-Jalani's story on you just aired.
Hi.
I don't blame you for walking out on her.
She was trying to distort my words.
Sir, she was going to make me look bad no matter what I said.
You're probably right. I guess it could have gone a lot worse. Just wanted to let you know what the response was back home. I won't keep you any longer. Fifth Fleet out.
Yeah. Fuck her. If I wasn't doing a Paragon playthrough, if I wasn't so into Paragon things, Upright probably would have hit her in the face. Horsehead, where are you at? It's Artemis Tau. Argus Rao. Horsehead. Okay, well, we're gonna see which system we need to go to first. Journal. Hostile takeover. Fortuna. And the Horsehead Nebula. How many systems do we got? Only three? We're gonna have to check out that other system.
Commander, just came in over a secure channel.
Shepard, this is Admiral Gohoku. I found out who set that trap for my men. The ones killed by the Threshamore. Damn, I hope you get this message. It was a group called Serpers. An Alliance Black Ops organization. Top secret, highest level security clearance. They vanished a few months ago. Dropped right off the grid. Nobody knew where they went or what they were up to. They've gone completely rogue, Shepard. They're conducting illegal genetic experiments, trying to create some kind of super soldier. I don't have any proof, but I found the coordinates for one of their research worlds. I'm uploading them with this message. They're completely out of control. Somebody needs to stop them. I've done my part. Now it's up to you. This is probably the last you'll hear from me. Cerberus is after me now. I need to disappear before they find me.
And that is our first quote-unquote encounter with Cerberus. Terran insignia. While scanning the planet Magnalis, you discovered the remains of a damaged research vessel. Your recon team find no signs of survivors, but they did bring back a ROCOM outpost insignia. Felion. Rare element, plutonium. We will come back here in a moment. Yeah, okay. I'm a Riffian. Okay. Helena's hideout. Helena's hideout. Pretty sure it's Helena. Never hurts to save, so we'll just do that real quick. We can be diplomatic about this. I hope. I think it might just be her in here. Holy shit!
Hello again, Commander Shepard. I owe you a debt of gratitude. With my former partners dead, this syndicate is now mine. I could not have done it without you.
She scared the absolute crap out of me. I'm not done yet.
I killed them because they deserve it. Now I'm placing you under arrest.
Surely you don't think that necessary. Under my leadership, this organization will restrict itself to gambling and smuggling illegal technologies. These crimes are hardly worth your time. If you press the issue, my assistants are very well equipped to deal with you.
Walk away, Helena.
This gang has a reputation for drugs and slaving. It's too late to change that.
Perhaps you're right. Perhaps this organization has been so tainted by those two idiots that it cannot be redeemed. If I disband the gang, I walk away freely. I have not come so far to be arrested. I would die before going to prison. I would most certainly kill before going to prison. Now, do we have a deal?
For now.
You're free to go. I don't ever want to see this gang again. If I do...
You won't. I'm not so foolish as to break my word to a Spectre. Now, if you'll excuse me, my men become nervous in the presence of law enforcement agents. Goodbye, Shepard.
Okay, so that is one more quest under our belt. Let's go find these privateers. The Strinia system and the Horsehead Nebula. Funny enough, we were just about to head over there. Hopefully I'll get to test out my gun. I want to kill something. It's been so long since I've killed something. Yonthral. Medallion recovered. Your scan on an uncovered an ancient deep space probe slowly orbiting Yonthral. Tali brought it on board, dismantled it, and found a League of One medallion hidden in its payload. Good on you, Tali. Good on you. Healing and free. Trilene. I did see that right there. That's the ship. Why is it telling me there's a level 1 cold hazard right there? Am I gonna have to go to Grand? I feel like I might have to go to Grand. Well, let's go find the MSV Majesty. We're gonna scan it though. Ship is derelict. All compartments are exposed to space and the fusion plant is leaking. The damage is consistent with a ship-mounted mass accelerated fire. Faint trail of radioactive particles, possibly exhaust from a sublight nuclear engine drive, leads towards the nearby planet of Axowin. Guess we're going to Axowin. Can I interact with it? I can. Make a quick little save. I thought you had to blow it up or something. Discovery. There appears to be no one left at this camp. The generator is still functioning, but there are no signs of the former occupants. The camp's computer notes several locations of interest. Okay. Helpful. Oh. We're gonna get to use my gun. Smiley face. Snipers. One down. That's three. I was going to say two. That's four. God damn it, man, gun please. A few guys at the back. Wow, they really didn't want anybody coming in here, did they? Mako plus. Mako plus! See if outside, and then see if when we get inside. Excuse me. We've been playing for 15 hours. Damn! Look at us. Nothing over here. Hey, I get to use my gun though. Pretty stoked about that. Frame rate. The frame rate. Oh my god, this gun is amazing. I forgot how good Spectre weapons were.
You must die.
Nope.
You must die.
Another sniper, I'm assuming. Well, man, that was pointless. That it? That everyone? Okay, make a quick little save, because we may have survivors. Hopefully we do. We don't. Unless they're up top. They're up top. Metagel. All of these lockers are locked. Makes sense. But we can't access them, which blows. My handgun is so good. I'm not even mad anymore. Not even remotely mad. Power junction. Okay, we'll save once more. This way I don't have to run the whole way back up. Ah. He's dead. Anomaly identified. You discovered the corpse of Captain Willem of the MSV Majesty. His stiff fingers are wrapped tightly around a small data pod. Take the data pod. Well, I got bad news for his brother. Well, we need to go to the Citadel and deliver the bad news, but if there's one good thing that came out of it, it's my pistol is a total badass. So good. Okay. Citadel. Okay. We get to inform Gareth of his brother's fate. Just for once, some good news.
Any news? Did you find my brother yet?
He's dead.
I found your brother's body. His ship was attacked by privateers.
Willem's dead? I guess I should have expected this. When his ship dropped out of contact, I just knew. But I kept hoping he might still be alive.
This must be pretty hard for you.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Thank you for finding him. It's better to know one way or the other. That's what they say, right? Please excuse me. I need to go make arrangements for his funeral.
For once, just some good news.
I haven't spent much time with Krogan before, Rex, and I have to say, you're not what I expected.
Right. Because you humans have a wide range of cultures and attitudes. But Krogan all think and act exactly alike.
Well, I didn't mean... Look, just forget I said anything.
Done.
Rex, overreacting a little bit, but, dropping it just as quick. Good on you, Rex. Good on you.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. XO Presley stands relieved.
Alright, folks, I think that's going to wrap it up for today. I think next time we're going to wrap up a few more side quests. There's one with a rogue VI in the Luna system, or the Sol system. So it's going to be these threes. These three. Because the rest of these are just collectibles. So next time we're going to wrap up all of these, and then we're going to get a start on our DLC missions. And then after that, we're going to get a start on our main missions. So yeah, as always guys, my name has been Edwin. If you guys enjoy the series, if you want to see more videos like it, be sure to leave a like, comment down below. If you don't like it, leave a dislike, let me know how you'd like to see the videos improve. But aside from that there, once again, I have been Edwin, also known as SOLIDSNAKEE, and I'll speak to you all next time. Later guys.